to whatever lies ahead while aging day by day. And I don't know where I'll be next or if I'll be at all. I'm not privy to life's protocol.
Well, guys, I've decided it's time to change out this tripod. It's been here a while, since about 2018 is when I built it. Starting to get kind of rotten. My cordage still looks good though. Paracord is tough. It's been on here for years. Here we go. Here's that one. I think we'll just retire this one. up under saw. I've had this thing for about 5 years now. Let's make us Black Friday deal's about to drive me crazy. This knife cost me a whole $1.50 in a secondhand shop. It's a cheap Taiwan knife. Got matches and a fish hook in there. But this knife will hold an edge, a razor sharp edge, and will hold it. I made that scabbard out of an old leather boot. There you have it. I put staples in it so I couldn't cut the string. Yep. For $1.50 cheap Rambo knife, survival knife, it holds a good edge. Of course, this Laplander saw, I think it's one of the best bushcrafting saws you can get. say we make a pot of coffee and test it out. That's what I say. Down to the last Bohican. That's what I needed to do. Let's open it up a little bit. waste coffee. It's never good. Never, never good. Nothing better than a cup of coffee on a cold, damp day. Well, good afternoon, folks. I hope everyone had a wonderful Thanksgiving. I know I did. And it's been peaceful. I got to come out into the woods and just kind of have some solitude and relax by the fire with a good cup of cowboy coffee. Pretty hard to beat cowboy coffee. I drink a lot of coffee at home, but that percolator runs that water through so quick, you just really don't get a brewed cup of coffee that's good. But this is. I want to thank everyone that watches my videos. I know they're pretty much on amateur level, but I'm striving to do better. And in the next few videos, I'm going to do some reviews on some equipment that I bought. I bought an economy down sleeping bag that I heard about from Dixie on her YouTube channel. And the wife bought me some Hoka shoes, because that's what her podiatrist recommended. And guys, they're amazing. They're not cheap, but they are amazing. And I did 45 miles in mine a while back, and I didn't have any foot problems, nor did I have any hot spots. I wore those shoes, those Hoka shoes, with smart wool socks, and I wore a little lighter sock rather than the heavy smart wool socks. And 14 miles, I did 14 miles straight, didn't have a hot spot one, didn't have any feet issues the next day. And I've heard Jeremiah Stringer talk about these Hoka shoes, and there's another gentleman that just talked about them in a review. I want to say Justin Outdoors, but I'm not sure it was him. But anyway, I had never heard of Hoka shoes until my wife came home with a pair. But since then, I followed the old codgers on their hike of the PCT, the Pacific Crest Trail. And they went to trail days there, and there was a Hoka booth set up there. And now it seems like I'm hearing lots of folks talk about them. So I'll do a review on these after I put a few more miles on them, but I'm loving them. And I'm loving the Smart Wool socks. I have just about done away with all cotton socks. And gone strictly to Darn Tough or Smart Wool or brands like that. Thinking about trying a pair of alpaca socks. I'm seeing a lot of them advertised. If you've tried those, let me know in the comments what you think about them. Well, guys, I'm going to finish this cup of coffee. Be sure this fire's out. Head to the house. Hope everyone has a great rest of their weekend. And until I can talk with you again on my next adventure, I pray y'all stay safe. This is a wandering graybeard. Get out into the woods. It's good for the body. It's good for the soul. This peace and quiet's good for the mind. As my friend Ray would say, it's also great for the spirit. Here's to you. Adios.